Hello guys, and a very warm welcome to today's video, where we are in a Ryanair Boeing 737-800 series aircraft. We are Ryanair 438 Hotel, and we are flying today Palma, Mallorca to London Stansted. Nothing really much to prep for on the outside of the aircraft. The catering service is just taking place. We'll get the boarding very, very shortly. We're currently not on a Ryanair stand at the moment, actually, at Palma. We're currently over where the BA City Flyer parks. If you go for a tour, if we go into the cockpit view and we go for a cheeky look around, there should be a number somewhere around on the ground, but, you know. So, like I say, guys, today we are off to London Stansted, and hopefully after Stansted we'll be then on to somewhere else. But anyways, we'll come down into the first FMC and we will start setting up while everything's happening on the outside. It would be quite helpful if we knew what gate we was actually at, and I believe we will. And I'll just do this. 122, there we go. So we're at gate 122. We'll come back down into the FMC now and we'll stick 122 into the gate. And we'll use the gate's position in it reference per bit. Leppa, and like I say, we're off to London Stansted today. Cruising at 380, we're at Echo India, Delta Yankee Zulu. So if we go Echo India, standby. I just got to try and find something, guys. Delta Yankee Zulu. And that can now be started, so there we go. We can close the cargo doors now, and we can also now request boarding. Ryanair 438 Hotel, 438 Hotel. I can go in, not in the code route, sorry, in the flight number. And by the winds today, we can automatically tell ourselves that it's variable 2 knots, so it will be a runway 24 right departure on a Gala 1 Alpha. There we go. Route. That's fine. Just come into the route section now, and it goes to Gala UN 861 to Toulouse. So up in November 861 to Toulouse. After Toulouse, it's Up Yankee 120 to Chala. A-L-A, I think that's Chala. I think that's it, yeah, it is, brilliant. Chala. To Up Yankee, direct Tupar. Direct Tupar. Rip, double R. In goes Tupar, and after Tupar it's direct to, oh no, it's UN8, Upper November 861 to AMG, 61 to ANG. There we go. Next page. Then it's UN861, so we direct Dicro. And after that quote, it will then be direct to UN863. 863 to Avant. A-V-A-N-T. Avant. There we go. What more could you want? Activate that. Execute. Everything seems okay. Now we should head to the Perth init page. We'll see if there's a fuel weight in there. Reserves today will be carrying 2.9 tons in the reserves. Cost index today of 5. Cruising at 380. Transition out here is 6,000 feet. Execute that. M1 limit or M1 limit page. We'll go 55 in the cells, 26k or 24k D rate, that'll be fine with us today. And just dig it back into 55. Takeoff today, we're using flaps 5 for takeoff. Set the trim of 5.02. Doesn't have to be bang on, but it's around there somewhere. Okay then, so the runway's inactive, so runway active today. The winds are variable, so we will need to try and get the wind from the sun there. Wind 2203 knots, so we'll stick that in, 220 at 3. No, the runway condition is dry. That's okay, class from mass 1, cutback, that's fine. And hopefully now we can set our speeds in like so. Brilliant. Not really much more we can do, to be honest. We'll go to the MCP in just a second. Okay then, so what we could do now is we'll set all our speeds into the MCP. It'll be 142 in there. Well, both flight directors can actually now come on. So there we go. And after departure, we'll just climb up to 6,000 feet. Everything seems okay. RTO there. Overhead panel now. I can conclude all the stuff up here. Window heats can now come on. Circulation fans. We'll stick the cruising altitude in there of 38,000 feet. That's what we've flown out today, isn't it? Yes, it is. Brilliant. We can now start the APU, but we're also in starting the APU. We need to remind ourselves of the strict APU policy here at Mallorca, so we'll just have to remember that. We'll close the cargo doors. Ah, oh, brilliant. And we'll pushback today will be a nose right, tail left, and we can actually prep for that in just a second. Just come back down into the FMC, sorry, and go ground connections. We'll set the parking brake ourselves, and also what we can do is we'll come down here and we'll set Unicom because there's no ATC online. We'll go 122.8. Don't know why the TCAS number just comes on, but you know, 2,200 go in there. We can have a quick TCAS test, I reckon. Squeeze ourselves a quick TCAS test. Overhead panel to have the APU now. And we'll lose the wheel chucks. We'll go back to the doors page now. No. Oh, wow. I just pressed the air stair button by mistake. Rest in peace, Hairstairs. Wow. Okay, well now I actually think we have MLG fixed the doors. But all the passengers are boarded, all the boarding is complete. So we'll close the doors which we need to close. And they head now towards the legs page. Brilliant. Rip. The lag is real. That's okay. Everything does actually seem fine now, and hopefully now we can proceed with our pushback. So the GSX is disconnecting from us, and hopefully very very shortly we will be underway. Wait for it to go, and then we'll set taxi lights. Taxi light can come on. There we go. Set flaps 5. I always struggle doing this without looking. There we go, flaps 5. Have a good trip, there we go. So at least the parking brakes, we can now start our taxi out. It's runway 24 right. I'll loosen up my pedals a bit, they're a little bit stiff. There we go. So we'll be now coming to the left hand turn here. We'll have terrain, we'll have traffic on my display. Oh yeah, we'll have train and traffic on my display. Okay then. So now we are on track.
I didn't answer. It's perfect, got you.
So we will commence a right-hand turn in just a second. See, we could have come this way. We could have taxied over nose left tail right and come out of here, but we didn't. Because I always remember, or if I think myself correctly, when the inbound come down south, which is this taxi we're on now, and this link, yeah, well, when they come down link or south, they then go like left there, but you know, I'm just ignoring that. So we're currently turning on to north now. That's what I love, the taxiways here at that taxiway was just on this link. I love the taxiways here at Majorca because it's so easy to. It's not like, for example, back in the UK, or back at Gatwick, for example, you've got Quebec, Sierra, and Juliet, Yankee, or whatever. Here at Majorca, you've just got north, south, east, west, and like Foxtrot, and I think there's like a couple of like connecting taxiways, like November, for example. But it's so much easier, I believe. Okay then, so, got to be careful, because we're speeding a bit, but obviously there's no traffic around us. Turn-offs can now come on, we'll lose the taxi lights for the time being. We'll have a weather throttle now, and also what we'll do is we'll have weather on the first officer's display. Come down here now, we'll have the TCAS on. Cabin crew, seats for departure please, thank you. Tell you what, I know the retractable lights obviously retract out of the aircraft due to large and stuff, but I've got to say, I love how it's simulated on the NGX. I will show you guys in just a second. So currently Hotel 3, 24 right, we'll be departing in about a minute's time now. Clear on the approach. Well, I know that because there's nothing on the TCAS which is coming in, so we're all okay. And also there's nothing on VASPY, so... And also 24 left is the arrival runway at Palma, so if you land 24 right then you're a bit of a noob. Okay, so we'll stop here for the time being. That's all fine. Now, this is where I love it. This is where it's simulated the best. Watch the retractable lights come out of the fuselage. Look at that. I didn't actually know. I thought they just dropped straight away. I didn't actually know they had a bit of a time sort of restriction. Well, not time restriction, but sort of time on them. Takes like a couple of seconds to come down. I thought it just like dropped instantly. But brilliant bit of simulating there from PMDG. Anyways, enough about that. So then guys, we'll slowly increase now the throttle. Wait till stable. And we'll go toga. Turn up the volume guys. Turn up the volume guys if you love a bit of hardcore NGX sound. There we go. ~100 knots. V1. Rotate. Rotate. So there we go then, guys. We've departed from Majorca. Positive rate of climb, gear up. Okay then guys, so what we'll do now is we will now go command A and wait for the autopilot sound to go. Command A, we'll go level change up to flap 1. We'll go on LNAV as well. So then guys, there it is. We have officially departed from Palma, Majorca on a quite a hazy warm day, and we will see you on our final approach in to London Stansted. See you all very, very shortly. Hello then, guys, and a very warm welcome on our final approach into London Stansted. Now, it's not very busy around Stansted at all, so we're going to completely ignore the arc, and we're just going to come round now. On the heading 050 degrees, speed back 235 knots, down to 3,500 feet, and as you can see in front of us, there is a lovely bit of cloud, and at the moment around Essex, there is some rain, cloud, everything possible, which could cause a havoc to a landing. So we're all programmed in, landing today at runway 22, London Stansted. We are obviously en route from Palma, and we're just passing now flight level 80. Not really much to talk about, really. We're just trying to go, well, we're going to try and get down as quick as possible today, obviously, because we don't all get through the cloud as quick as possible today. This is obviously due to certain issues which could come, obviously, when we're flying through the cloud. We could have certain problems such as severe turbulence and proceed from like that. Also, you can probably tell Rexsoft clouds in use, which is absolutely lovely. Just that gives it that sort of soft touch, and it's a lot more. I've realised since using Rex clouds, the weather does look a hell of a lot more realistic. So, anyway, we're just passing flight level 70 now. We're going to go down straight down to 3,000 feet now. Anyway, so what we'll do now is we'll come off of the standard and set local QNH 996 hectopascals. And what we'll do now is we will lose the terrain off the radar because it prevents me from seeing like properly where we are actually heading. Increase to 240, try and get that vertical speed down a bit more. So we're just past the 6,000 feet, then we're on the heading 060 degrees. We've picked up the DME for runway 22 as well. We are currently about 6, or is that 8 or 6 DME? I think it's about 6.5 DME out. We won't commence our right-hand turn just yet until we're at a stable altitude where I think we'll be able to proceed. As you can roughly tell now, going through some horrible cloud and you can't really see the ground at all. It's just starting to faintly see the ground there as well, so when we go through this cloud, like I say, we're going to try and get through it as quick as we possibly can. Okay then. Right hand turn now is 075 degrees. Here we go, we're breaking through the cloud now. Okay, then down to, when we hit 3,000 feet, we'll then decrease the speed to about 180. Okay then, so now what we'll do is we'll bring the speed back 180 knots and we'll go down on vertical speed. This really is where this cloud kicks in, and visibility wise absolutely awful, unfortunately. Okay, 160 now, that's what we'll try and hit as best we can. We'll complete now, we'll decrease the vertical speed to 750 and we'll commence a right hand turn now of 140 degrees just until we can level off. And we'll go flaps 1. Okay, then now what we'll do is also is go right hand turn now to 185 degrees, and on that heading we are clear to establish the localizer runway 22 at Stansted. Actually, we'll go around now 190 to establish. And what we'll do as well is we'll come up here, the landing lights can come on, they can go to continuous, everything else seems okay. We'll go now flaps 5, VOR localizer. And down to 2,000 feet using vertical speed. And what we'll do now is we'll hit our final approach speed, which I want to be about 140 today. Absolutely horrible weather, it's absolutely awful. But I suppose what you can say is this is the UK. There we go. Gear down. Engage the approach, select command B. If we can come, so I want to try and get a better view of the flap speeds. Okay, then we'll lose speed brake now. Flaps 15. Arm the speed brake. Flaps 25. Going through some apps. The weather is absolutely awful. We will just double check there's no ATC on the ground at Stansted. There's one to depart, this is the FedEx, and there's one to arrive, which is absolutely brilliant. So we've got them just established now. Localizer descended on the glide. Flaps 30, speed brake is armed. It'll go to go around altitude, can go in there. I can't see where we're going. So what we're going to do is we will maintain 2,000 feet. We'll maintain on the autopilot and on the cat-free approach until we actually proceed to see the ground. Because the last thing is this is what the perfect weather for an auto land is. So, I just mean Jesus, look at the weather. Absolutely awful. This is what you really test if you are a good pilot. I mean, look at the speed as well. We'll just double check flaps are 30. 1,000 feet, flaps 30, that's fine. Oh god, the auto throttle thing's going to keep going until we can try and get the speed back. There's the runway. But I'm not going to risk disengaging the autopilot for this one, guys. It doesn't look like until we actually get break through this cloud. We've got the runway in sight, though. Fifteen knot crosswind as well. Jesus, look at the wind. There's the runway. There we go. Aircraft is mine. Wind is really, really kicking in there. Landing. Good job, it's a long runway. There we go, we're down. Do not care what you say, I was pleased to get that down. Rip. Okay, so we'll just stop here for a moment to clean up.
Thanks for flying Ryanair. Over 90% of our flights arrived on time last year. We hope you enjoyed yours. Ryanair. Low fares, made simple. Please arrive in your seat. Once we have stopped, be careful opening overhead lockers, items of your luggage may fall out and cause injury to you.
Okay then guys, so we're just gonna taxi off. So I just had to stop there and clean up and sort of just get the aircraft sort of sorted, if you understand what I mean. Landing rate today was minus 95, which is quite nice. Lag is real. Off come the wipers now, because that's causing some havoc. Okay then guys, so we'll just taxi off now to a gate. Unfortunately, the one thing is with the runway 22, when it is active at Stansted, is the horrible pain of the long taxi. Anyway guys, so there we go. Very, very poor weather approach. I mean, the weather is simulating perfect, because this is what the weather actually is like at Essex at the moment. We cleaned up there straight after vacating, just because sometimes you normally end up forgetting stuff. All I can say really though guys is a massive yet again thank you for yet again tuning in on today's service from Palma, Mallorca to London Stansted. Be sure to hit that like and that subscribe button guys, it really much is appreciated. Just going to conclude by taxiing off to the gate. So just down hotel at the moment. I suppose it's a bit of a difference when you're coming from Palma, it's been 26 degrees and just land at a 13 degree Stansted. It's just pouring down a rain. Oh, what more could you want? okay then, so we'll just clean up on the MCP now. I can get ready for the next crew. Everything does actually seem okay. Look at the weather though. I mean, when you get rain on flights, you get rain, but this is normally, this rain just seems different. It's really heavy rain. I wish it was simulated falling onto the sort of windows. That would be really cool if it was simulated like that, but clearly it's not. This is what I mean by the long taxi. It's just not like loved at all, is it? Also Ryanair, they park right at the end. So, you know. Anyway then guys, we're almost at the gate which I wanted to be at. Should we use a jetway? I'm just thinking because it's raining, but then again this is Ryanair, so they'd probably expect you to wait outside the plane in the pouring rain for the bus. But yeah, minus 95 landing rate guys, I'm not going to lie. I'm actually quite pleased with that. And a flight time of 2 hours and 37 seconds. That's the good thing about Palma. Everyone loves the pure love of just... Oh god. Yeah, everyone loves the short flight time. Push. Pain is real. Come on. Taxi's so long. That's why I loved it if it was runway 04 in use. Because you just got like land and you just roll out on auto brake one to the end. Or yeah, auto brake one, no reverse, just roll out all the way to the end. Okay then, so we'll bring it round. I'm gonna be kind to the passengers today, I think. But the thing is, the Stansted is, which is why I think they're making a new Stansted, is because the jetways are so laggy. And they just, sometimes they're not loved at all. Just thinking of a wing. Don't want to be hitting the Air Berlin's wing. Oh well. I'm sure they won't mind. Oh, come on, we need to get a good park in here. There we go. Looks like we won't be using the jetway then. Set parking brakes. Down we come. Off comes the engines. Wait for them to shut down before we can clean up on the overhead. Okay, the overhead panel, time to clean up. Will you stay on APU for the time being? Hydraulic pumps can come off. We'll lose the wipers. Off come probes. Off come window. Off comes yaw. Off comes the packs. Off comes anti-coal. Off comes everything else which is not required. Now we can request deboarding, which is brilliant. Is there a front stairs? Bet there isn't. That is not. Rip. Enjoy your jetway. Want to work? No. Welcome to the order, Stansted. So. There we go. Passengers are going to have to get wet. And what we can do now is we can do that, and that, and that. And also we'll have the ground connections as well. Lose APU, lose that. So there we go then, guys. All the way from Palma, Mallorca to London Stansted. So like I say, guys, be sure to hit that like, the subscribe button, and be sure to comment as well if you want to see a video in the future. Let us know. I'm sure it can be done. So guys, a massive thank you for tuning in, and until the next video, guys, Auf Dankeschön, Auf Wiedersehen.